Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video. In this video, I'll show you how to do a parallax effect in Fusion. This is one of the effects I've been using the most. I've been using this by bringing old photos to life in documentaries, and I've been using different techniques. I've been using a technique where I did it in After Effects and Photoshop. I've been doing a technique where I did a lot of the photo work in Photoshop, and then I did everything inside of DaVinci Resolve in the editing tab. But in this video, I'll show you how to do all of it inside of Fusion, inside of DaVinci Resolve 16. So without further ado, let's get right to it.
Okay, so let's just get started here. We have a photo. And the first thing we are going to need to do is we are going to the color page. We need to do a clean plate. You can do this in a great variety of ways, but I'll show you the fastest way to do this. And of course, you could. I'm not sure if you can do that if you do not have the studio version, because we're going to use the new object removal for this one. So anyway, if you're interested, I'll do a tutorial on how to do a clean plate and basically do the same effect without using the object removal, but this is just a very quickly tutorial. So in the color page, we are just going to go into our mask, and we are going to do a curved mask, and we're just going to basically draw a shape around our subject here, and we'll just finish that. Then we'll just use Alt-S to do a new note, and I'll connect the two notes together with the blue line here, and then I'll just copy it, and I'll search for the object removal, and I'll drag the object removal onto the clip. And assume no motion. I'll just click that, because there is no motion. It's a still photo, and I'll just build a clean plate out of that. And, it's maybe not the best clean plate in the world, but it's good enough for Jazz. So back to the editing page, I'll make this into a new composition or a compound clip. So I'll drop down another photo on top of that. I'll make this into a new Fusion clip, and then I'll go to Fusion. And here we are. And it has now already put things together. I'll just toggle down the media pool here. And we'll just push one to see what is in the viewer. That is the plate. So I'll push F2 to name my plate. And I'll just call this plate. Just like that. And let's just name the top layer here. I'll just call that me, because that is me. Way back. Okay. And then we'll just rearrange a bit. Okay, so I'll just do a polygon here. I'll just select the polygon, actually, and I'll just reconnect these again. Sometimes this, to be sure that that I am the foreground and the plate is the background. Okay, so let's just, again, go on the me layer. And then let's just take the polygon, and then we'll just draw a shape. I'll just use the plus and minus buttons to go in closer. And again, I'm not going to do this way beautiful or anything. I'm just going to do this super duper fast. Like so. So if you have a lot of time, you can do a better job than I am doing. But this is just for the sake of the tutorial and keeping down the length of the tutorial. And we'll just quickly make a shape around me here. And then if there is any shadows, make sure to use those as well, as I have some here. And let's just continue around like so. No, it's not going to be 100% okay, but it'll be good enough for the tutorial, I think. And we'll just move around a bit here, and then let's finish off. Oh, whoops. just control set that for 1 second, and then let's make it a little bit better though. Okay, almost there, and let's just do the last ones here. There we go. Again. And let's connect them together like so. There we have it. Okay, and then we just need to connect our polygon to the me layer. Like so, and then now we have the me layer. Alone and the background. Okay, so we'll just push control and spacebar, and then just write in warp, and I'll just use the grid warp to do a super quick animation. And I do not want to have it here. So sometimes you are on the wrong node and it will just put those in together, but no big problem. So I'm just going to connect this after the me layer and before the merge. And then we have, first off, I'm going to make the size smaller and also going to make the strength smaller. And I'm going to make the grids, large those a little and something like so. Again, this is a super quick way of doing it. So we might do a more in-depth tutorial on how to make this parallax effect actually. But anyway, let's just do a quick animation just by right-clicking and from the beginning and then going to the end of our timeline. And then we'll just make some, just again, I'll zoom in, I'll make a change. Something like that. And let's see, make this a little bit smaller. So it is, the trick here is to not make the face look too pushed and stretched and unnormal. And I find out that in like a general rule when you're doing this is that you think you're going to do a very little thing, but you should push it a little more actually. Then you think, because if the movements are not big enough, you're not going to see it very well at all. So now I'm just adjusting a bit, and then we have to have a look at how it actually looks. So I think also I want my feet here to move a bit actually. That would maybe be fun. And it's just super small and very subtle, this effect. So. And then again, you can use a lot of time on moving the picture around, and it's a bit easier now because it's only the layer with me on I am manipulating right now. So let's say something like that, and then let's just go to the output here, and then let's have a look at it. So we again here it's like I talked about, if you do the movements too small, you will hardly see the movement. It's there, but it's not that visible. And maybe that is the effect you're going for. So let's just, I want to do a little more. So I'll just go back to the grid warp, go back to the last frame where I did put the key frame. And then I am going to push everything a bit more. So let's just move my head a bit more. Something like that. Oh, by the way, this is a super old photo. I think that is from like 84 or something. It's really, I think I'm around 4 or 5 years or something like that. So around 84, 85, something, long time ago. You know, back when VHS were a thing, and today nobody knows what it is. So that's, or cassette tapes. Anyway, I'm getting old now. So, okay. Anyway, back to the tutorial and away from the memory lane here. Again, Now I'm going to push the animation a bit more here and to make it a bit more visible, I think. It will help pretty well. And you know, there's nothing wrong in making it a bit too large. It's easier to make it smaller again. Something like that. And then I think we also want to let's make the legs move a bit more as well. Something like that. Okay, something like that. Let's have a look at that. Okay, and as you might see now, it is a bit more visible what's actually going on. And I actually like this kind of thing pretty well. A nice effect. But then again, I think we will go in the merge node and I'll just add some motion blur as well. Make it a little more filmic. Okay, and then was one last thing here. I will take a transform and hold down shift and just connect it to the line with the line here. And then I'm going to the beginning of my time line and I'll put in a keyframe and I'll go to the end. And then I'll just make a little zoom, which will make this photo a little more interesting to watch. Oh, here we have it with that little effect done. Okay, and let's just do a little bit more by going back to the editing tab here and just have a little look at our animation. Pretty good, I think. So let's just add a super small little thing, which will make this kind of fit into our theme of the 80s here. So I'll just go to our open effects and then I'll just scroll down here and I will take my analog damage. I have that right here. I'll just drag that on. Again, that is one of the new filters in DaVinci Resolve 16. I do not know if that's only going to be in the studio version and also in the free version. So I'll just put in this presets old VHS. Let's just take clean VHS a little better. Okay, so let's have a look at that. Just like it would have looked back in the 80s. Lovely. I'll just go into the color tab as well and then I'll just do a little about. I'll just make black a bit more black by dragging down the lift and then I'll take a little of the saturation out and dial down the gamma and the gain a little bit, something like that. There you have it, me back in the 80s. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.